Hey yo, it's your boy Julian.
Say your name.
Hey yo, it's your boy Julian and we here.
What's going on? It's your boy Nas.
But we here, we're doing album reviews and we're doing music reactions. So today we're talking about Dabba Ranch by Migos. The criteria we got for our little review right here is the meaning behind the song.
What it would sound like, where it could be played at. You know, like the standouts, parts of the lyrics, how the song was composed, you know, the backgrounds of it. Yeah. And will it last if it has, you know, if it has that power to go on 20 years and like if our grandchildren be rapping along to it.
And that's the most important Dabba part. Ranch. That Dabba Ranch, you know.
That was nice,
So, we want to know from you guys, go and listen to it, you know, the link is in the description below, and let us know, do you think this song is going to last, or is it just something so they can sell their chips that they got out? So, we're going to go ahead and start. Alright, so what's the meaning behind the song?
The meaning behind the song is in, you know, a Dabba Ranch.
Dabba Ranch.
You want a Dabba Ranch, you know, they have a bag of chips. So the Migos have their own chip, not chip. There is a chip company that has their own chip right now. And the star product right now is the Dabba Ranch flavor, which features all three members of the Migos on it. So when they found out about this, which they probably found out a while ago, but they didn't think it was going to probably blow up the way it did. So now that it blew up the way it did, they went in the studio, got, you know, Dabba Ranch bags, you know, yum, yum, yum. And they made a song off it. They were playing around at first. They were just making it, you know, the joke around, but then it became an actual song. Mm-hmm. And now we got the actual song.
It's part of the Rap Snacks brand, the one that had Lil Romeo on it a couple years ago. They had that joint on it. That's where they come from. You know.
Barbecuing with my honey.
Yeah, that was the title. It's been a long time.
I wanna play the song because I'm actually kind of like, I'm actually.
Let's
ladies and gentlemen. Dabba Ranch.
Wanna play Dabba Ranch?
My amigos.
You know, you woke up and you don't know what to do. And you're a little hungry. Brush that with a Dabba Ranch. It's just for you. Hey! Woo! With a Dabba Ranch, with a Dabba Ranch, with a Dabba Ranch, we can make it get happy.
Ooh.
That was the hook? That was the hook alone.
My G, that's 50 seconds of the song!
Alright, what about the hook? Before you even get into the first verse. Just the hook alone.
Alright.
Catchy, very catchy.
It is catchy. I can say that.
It's heavy.
Coming from this generation of music, I can say people will most likely bump to this. I can say that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think it will be just played as a joke, you know, on the radio maybe once or twice, honestly.
I think it's going to be something where it's just like when people find out about the song, they're going to run to their local poppy store, get a bag, just to Snapchat it while playing, like, all right, first verse. Growl! Brow!
Get with the ranch, back a lick, even crumbs on your lips. Chuck long back in the big new shipment. Gotta take them up. Take off. Bad look magical. Good, they smackable.
First verse by,
okay,
Young Quavo.
So money like bag of chips, hundreds of bags I flip.
Finger licking with the ranch, leaving crumbs on your lips. That's a heater right there.
Truckload backing up beep. New shipment. Gotta stack them up. Take off. Bag look magical.
Oh yeah, bag looking magical. Good and smackable. That was one of the hardest parts. Like, if you listen to it and you hear that part, that's the part that you're like, wow.
Yeah. Honestly, listening to it, you know, and getting into it, I really think it's just, it's stupid.
Definitely.
It's stupid. But, you know, if it works for them, it works for them. Mm-hmm. I ain't gonna be mad.
I think, like, this could probably be, like, I could see this being played at a party, probably something like this weekend, actually. I actually see it being played at a party this weekend.
Really?
I guarantee. Really? Let me explain. I feel like this weekend, like, towards like the end of a party, there's gonna be a DJ playing around and just somehow like throws us in there, plays like good like 30 seconds of to see people just like, hey, what a dab of ranch. And I guarantee there's gonna be somebody leaving that party that's gonna be off of some Henny, shout out to Young and May, who's gonna be off of that Henny, and they're gonna be like, oh my god, when I heard the bag of ranch, the dab of ranch song, and like, oh my god, we gotta go to the Poppy store, we gotta get the bag of ranch chips.
Like, we gotta try it. Like,
yeah, I could definitely see somebody doing that this weekend.
Know what we should do? We should get a bag of these chips.
I had bags, you know. For the next video. If I may also add, there are four flavors actually. I found out about the fourth flavor today. There is the Dabba Ranch flavor by the Migos. There is the Barbecuing with My Honey by Little Romeo. There is the Honey Jalapeno by Fetty Wap. And there's a new flavor called Louisiana Heat by Lil Boozy, aka Boozy Badass. We've had the first three. The only one, Boozy Badass one's only in Louisiana. But the first three, we did like a sampling of the three of them. Personally, my favorite was the Honey Jalapeno by my boy Fetty Wap, Jersey, Zuvia, 1738, all the way to 1300. Sorry about that.
I gotta say the Dabba Ranch was my favorite genre, for real, honestly. I mean, look. If you guys had this stuff, actually go out and try it first off.
Definitely.
You to comment down in the comments below and, you know, let us know. Let us know what you guys thought, honestly.
Please do. Is it about that time?
Yeah, it's about that time. All right, to our last segment, which is, you know, the real question is, will it last? Is it just like a marketing technique, or is this drone going to be like the next Ooh, or the next, you know, Bad and Bougie? Or I don't think it has that potential at all, but I mean, like, what do you think?
I think it's gonna probably be like, you remember when Little Yachty did the Sprite commercial and he was like, cool like a Sprite soda, cool like, I can see it blasting that same amount of time, but I can't see it like, I can't see like a whole year from now somebody like bumping down the street playing this song like, oh my god, this is such a golden song.
Okay, so alright. Do you think this is where rap is heading?
Rap is heading in the trash pit. I'm gonna keep this short and sweet. Rap music, as in the rappers, like the people that can genuinely rap, they're good. They're in their own lane. Rap is still progressing. You can see that people are learning from the others. But as far as like this bubblegum pop, the mainstream rap, that's what I should say. Mainstream rap, that's already going in trash. No disrespect to the Migos. You know, they obviously doing their thing. I salute them. But, yeah. I'm a rap fan. Like Dave East. Shout out to the guy Dave East. So slept on to him.
Shout out to Isaiah Rashad.
Woo!
Shout out to you know, obviously Kendrick and Cole. I'm saying that right here and right now.
And Big Sean's album. Oh, I might have spoiled something.
Might be talking about it soon, you know. Yo, keep quiet about that.
I'll shut up.
Alright, thanks guys. And remember, like, comment, and subscribe. You know?
Please like, comment, and subscribe. Send this to your friends, send it to your mama, send it to your mama, send it to your daddy, send it to your dad, send it to your baby daddy, send it to everybody so we can get famous. We trying to get out of here. But please, thank you for your time. Have a wonderful evening. Goodbye.
That was so awkward.